Hello, good day viewers. You're welcome to my YouTube channel. This is Chemistry Hangout. Today we are going to be looking at the question number 2 for the WAEC 2021 chemistry practical. If you are new to this channel or you are watching this channel for the first time, I will actually urge you to subscribe to this channel, and you can check my previous video. I have done the number 1 for 2021 chemistry practical. Yes, I've done justice to that on this channel. So I will urge you, if you are new to this channel, to check my previous videos for the number 1. Today we are going to be looking at the number 2 question for this year WAEC chemistry practical. And quickly, before we do that, I will actually thank my subscribers been sharing these videos. Of course, I want to appreciate them. That's wonderful. I really appreciate them. So let's keep sharing the videos. You know, it will help people massively. It will help a whole lot of students massively to improve. So please, let's keep sharing it, commenting, you know, tell people to subscribe to this channel. Tell somebody to subscribe, and that person also tells somebody to actually subscribe. And that's how we can grow. So I'm saying a big thank you to us. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Okay, so quickly, before we actually go into today's business, please, I will always urge us to come to this channel, because we are going to be having some practical sections. Yes, we are going to be having some practical sections on this YouTube channel. So not just for exams only, because I discover a whole lot of students come to this channel because of their exam, and they felt there will be something actually educating that will help them or aid them in their exams, and that's why they are coming here. But no, for us to be a better student, keep checking this channel. There are some practical sections that will be coming on this channel. So please just check this channel time to time. And that's the reason why I said, if you have not subscribed, please kindly do that. If you have not subscribed, please kindly do that. And if you have not clicked on the notification bell, please do that, so that when I drop any educative and exciting video like this, you would be aware. So quickly, today we are going to be looking at the number 2 question for WAEC 2021 chemistry practical, and that's the qualitative analysis. You know, I said it in my previous video, I'm not saying this is the exact thing that we actually come out, or this is the exact thing you will be giving, but I can assure you that 75% of what is being taught on this channel is going to come out. You are going to see it. So please watch this video to the end and try to follow those processes steps by steps, so that you actually understand. You can leave your comment on the comment box section, like this video, share, and subscribe to this channel. So very quickly, number 2, C is a mixture of 2 inorganic salts. Perform the following exercises on C. Record your observations and identify any gases involved. State the conclusion you draw from the results of each test. Okay, please, very, very important. State the conclusion you draw from the results of each test. And for A, they said dissolve all of C in about 10 centimeter cube, and we're going to be doing that now. So please pay attention. We know that for our qualitative analysis, before you start doing anything now, very, very important, we are going to have our test, okay? We are going to have our test. We have our observation. We're going to have a table, our observation, and we are going to have our inference, okay? We're going to have our inference. So our test, very important, our test, our observation, and our inference. So all this will be given to us in our center. All these reagents, your barium chloride, your sodium hydroxide, your dilute HCl, your conc HCl, and stuff like that will be given in our centers, and it will be adequately labeled. Okay, so for us now, instead, put dissolve all of C. For the exam, they might use D, they might use E. They are still saying the same thing, but I decided to use C for the sake of this very practical. So they said dissolve all of C in about 10 centimeter cube of distilled water. So this is my C now, okay? This is my C, and they asked me to dissolve all of C in 10 centimeter cube of distilled water. So I can have this, okay? I can have this. I can have this in my and in 10 centimeter cube of distilled water. So this is my distilled water, you can see H2O. Okay, so 10 centimeter cube, measuring with my measuring cylinder at 10 centimeter cube. Okay, 10 centimeter cube of distilled water. Added it to this. And that, I added it to this. Look at it, the first thing that has been observed, can you see effervescence is formed? Okay, look at that, can you see bubbling? I've said that in my last video, when you see bubbling, that's effervescence, which indicates the escape of gas. You can see bubbles forming here, very, very important now. So I can record that my C plus about 10 centimeter cube, or 10 centimeter, because I measured 10 centimeter cube of distilled water. Please, another thing very important, label accordingly. You can see, this is A. This is A, the double of C. C plus 10 centimeter cube of distilled water. What is my observation? My observation is, number one, I have effervescence occur, okay? I have effervescence occurring, that's the first thing. Can you see that? Very, very obvious. You can see, that's the effervescence now. Can you see? That's the effervescence. Now, after that, then I say, steer the resulting solution. I want to steer the resulting solution. Let me use my glass one, okay? Steer the resulting solution and filter. So, I'm steering the resulting solution. Steer the resulting solution, okay? And I want to filter now. Where's my filter paper? You can see that. You can just put this here first. Please gently just fold it to look like this. Okay? A funnel. Then open one end like that. Okay? Place it in my funnel. I can use my boiling tool just to filter. I want to filter. Filtering already. Can see that I'm filtering it already. Let's wait for some time so that we can. Can you see that? You can see? Okay, can you see that now? I'm filtering it already. Okay, let's wait. Look at that. Filtrate. You can see light blue. We have a light blue filtrate. You have a light blue filtrate. It's still filtering. Let's record that first. Very, very important. So you have, we said filter, keep the filtrate and the residue. Divide the filtrate into two portions. So for this now, effervescence occur, and we are having what? A light blue filtrate. Okay? A light blue filtrate and let's see the residue. Okay, look at the residue now. Look at the residue. Can we see that now? Look at the residue. That's a green residue. Some people say bluish green, but I'm saying that's a green, so that we don't disturb ourselves. So that's a green, a light blue filtrate and what? And green residue. Now from this, look at this. Which means, if I have a light blue filtrate and I have a green residue, and from here, if you look at this, they say C is a mixture of two inorganic salts. Can you see that now? Two is a mixture of two inorganic salts, meaning the two inorganic salts, one is soluble, one is insoluble, and that's why you're having a residue on top of the filter paper. So the one that is soluble is actually going down the filter paper, which is the filtrate now. Can you see that? Why this is the what? Is the residue. So we can have C, the inference now. Since I have effervescence of light blue filtrate and green residue, then I can say C is a mixture of two inorganic salts. Now, if you look at this, it is possible for them to say C is a mixture of two salts. If they say C is a mixture of two salts, meaning I'll come here and tell them C is a mixture of two salts. But since you are saying it is an inorganic salt, stated, it can be stated, it might not be stated. Either they say inorganic salt or salt, and then I record for them here. If it is just, since a mixture of two salts, then I will say, since a mixture of two what? Of two salts. Do we get that now? So, but if they are saying now that it's a mixture of two inorganic salt, definitely with my observation, it shows that perfect true C is a mixture of two inorganic salt. So they said keep the filtrate and the residue. So they are keeping the filtrate. I'm going to keep the filtrate. Very important, are keeping the filtrate and the residue. Now, according to the instruction, please follow their instruction strictly, please. Follow their instruction strictly. So the first portion of the filtrate, so this is the filtrate now. You can see nothing is coming out again, meaning, okay, we still have little, okay, we still have little of the filtrate. Okay, that's fine. Okay, so, that's fine. So we can just add this here. Then this is the filtrate. Can you see? This is a light blue filtrate. Okay. Now, from this now, they said we should divide the filtrate into two. I'm dividing into two. I'm using my test tube for this. So I have this. Divide it into two. So this one, this two. That's the filtrate. Because we'll be using the two. So let's see. To the first portion of the filtrate, add few drops of barium chloride. Very, very important now. Please, the numbering is very important. Look at this, B Roman figure one. So I have B Roman figure one. So the filtrate plus, okay, let's say first portion of the filtrate, first portion of filtrate, plus what now? Filtrate plus few drops of barium chloride. Plus barium chloride. That's aqueous. First is in the solution form. So let's see. Our barium chloride, you can see. These are barium chloride. So we add few drops of barium chloride to this. Let's see what's going to happen. Okay, look at that. Wow. Look at this. This is a white precipitate now formed. Can we see that? A white precipitate formed. Okay? So a white precipitate. On addition of barium chloride, what do you observe? You can see that now. This is a white precipitate formed. Okay? So we have white precipitate observed or formed. Anyone? Formed. Now, and I've told you in my previous video, for some of you that have watched that NECO video I did, if you are adding barium chloride to a particular solution and you have white precipitate, I told you three anions will be suspected. And what are those anions? Can be SO4 2 minus, okay? Can be CO3 2 minus or SO3 2 minus. Might be present. Either of these three anions will be present. Can we see that now? Either of these three ions will be present. From of the filtrate, an after drop of barium chloride followed by dilute HCl. So we now have plus HCl. Don't forget, I told you in that video, please go and watch that video for people that have not actually watched that video. If I'm adding dilute HCl to this now, If it is soluble, it means the two anions that will be there will be my SO3 2 minus and CO3 2 minus. Can we see that now? But if it is insoluble, if the white precipitate is insoluble in dilute HCl, it means it is SO4 2 that is present. SO4 2 minus that is present. So let's see our dilute HCl. You can see that this dilute HCl label, dilute HCl. And I have this. Can we see that? You are still seeing the white precipitate. You can see. The white precipitate did not dissolve. We are still seeing the white precipitate. Okay. So definitely, what will I record here? Precipitate. Undissolved. Or precipitate insoluble in HCl. Undissolved in dilute HCl. Then I will have that SO42 minus is what? Let's confirm. I hope we are following. So SO42 minus is what is confirmed. SO42 minus is confirmed for this because it is still insoluble. So we have SO42 minus confirmed. Okay. Now from this now, let me just put it here like this. Let's see. Okay, to the second portion now, you can see we are done with this. We have BII now. We have BII. Okay, second portion of the to the second portion, heat the mixture and bring a glass rod deep in concentrated HCl close to it. So we have second portion of vitreous plus heat. Can we see that now? Of heat and bring it very close. This is the same thing I did in the NECO video for some of you that you have actually watched that video. If you look at this, second portion, heat the mixture and bring it. You should know you want to test for what there? For ammonia gas there. Because I've said that when you this is a confirmatory test for ammonia. Yeah, for ammonia gas. This is a confirmatory test. I said that in that NECO video. That when you see, bring a glass rod deep in concentrated HCl close to it. You can use it to confirm for HCl or ammonia. Because there will be a white dense film there before. Okay, look at this. Let me quickly show you. This is an ammonia salt. This is an ammonium salt. Now, if I want to confirm if ammonia gas is being liberated here, this is a concentrated HCl. When I bring it very close to it, you see the white dense film. Because even without eating this at all, this opening this alone will liberate ammonia gas. Let's see. If I bring it very close to this, look at this. Look at it. Can you see? You can see the white dense film. Can you see that now? Can you see? Definitely, what you have here is an ammonium salt because ammonia will be liberated. So when you see, bring a glass rod deep in concentrated HCl, or you see concentrated HCl on that day, know what they are actually doing is what is ammonia. I've done that in a previous video, in that NECO video. Please. Actually work that. So if I have second portion of vitreous plus heat, can you see that now? Okay, let me quickly plus heat. Let's have this. Let's quickly do that for people that have not watched, for the sake of people that have not watched that. Okay. Let's quickly see that test. Very, very important. You can see, still bringing that. Even, it's not even close to it. Can you see? Can you see? That's a white dense film form, which is the confirmatory test for ammonia gas. Can you see that? You can see the white dense film now. Okay. So, from here, we can now go like this. They said the second portion is the mixture. So, where's the second portion that we are actually... Because we divided into two. This is the second portion. Can you see that? Divided into two. Let me use this as the holder because it will be hot. Okay. Let me use this as the holder. Passing the gas, you see. Let me dip. I said in the question, you know, I'm using the other end now of the glass rod. You know, I use this in steering. So I'm using the other end of the glass rod. You can see that. Can you see? Can you see that? Can you see the white dense film? Can you see? Can you see that? Correct. So from there, I can perceive that's a choking smell now. Okay, so I can have second portion of vitreous plus heat. So what do we have? A gas evolved with choking smell, okay, which turns red litmus paper blue. Can you see that? Now, because if you test that gas with your filter paper, because it's an alkaline gas, it will change it to what? It will change your red litmus paper to blue. So when a gas evolves with a choking smell, which turns red litmus paper blue, then we have what? Ammonia gas from NH4+. Can we see that now? Ammonia gas from NH4+. So the second one now said plus your glass rod. A glass rod dipped in concentrated HCl. I've shown us that practically. So you have what? A white dense film observed. And when you observe a white dense film, what is that? Ammonia gas is what is confirmed. Let me put that. Ammonia gas is confirmed. Wow, that's wonderful. That's the first test. We move to the C now. That will still be our test observation. You know, you are not going to write it again like test observation inference, you know, because you are just going to record everything like this. Because you cannot actually contain this, that's why I have to write this again, okay? So, observation and what? And inference, okay? So, and that will serve as the CI. Put all of the residue, okay? We are done with this. We are done with this. That's just what I need to do for this. You can see even, it's not even close to it. You can see the white dense film everywhere. You can see the white dense film. That's a confirmatory test. You can see that. You can see the white dense film, which indicates the what, the evolution of ammonia gas very close to a concentrated base. Okay, so put all of the residue. So we want to work with the residue now. We want to work with the residue now. Can you see? There's the green residue. We're working with the residue now. Okay. Working with the residue now. So I want to use a test tube because of the large surface area. I want to use a test tube. I think that would be better. And I wanted to use a test tube. Let me use this. Let me wash with water so that it will be as a larger surface area. Let me just wash with water. So let me use this. Wash with this still water again. As a larger surface area so that we can see the solutions. I hope we are following. So these are just simple tests that we can actually carry out that you've been scared. Just follow those processes. Now they said the CI now, and that's what the residue. Put all of the residue in a test tube and add. So the residue now plus dilute HCl. That's the test. The residue plus dilute HCl. That's the test. So this is the residue now. This is my spatula. Okay. All of the residue, you know what? Cannot be actually, although you can have a reasonable amount. That's the reason I'm using my test tube and my boiling tube. This is a boiling tube. That's, you know, it has this large area. So from there, plus dilute HCl down. Let's see. Dilute HCl. This is my HCl. Look at the reaction. Wow. Look at the reaction. Can you hear that sound? Can you see that now? So the first thing observed, you have effervescence. So from a residue plus dilute HCl, the first thing we observe is that our effervescence occur. Okay? effervescence occur. And you know, perceiving the gas is odorless. This is an odorless gas. This colorless, no color, but the gas has evolved and it is odorless. It's not breathing anymore. So that with an evolution of an odorless and colorless gas. Colorless gas. And I've told you that, you know, this ACL, the residue, meaning the residue is a carbonate salt. Can I see that? Because when you have ACL reacting with any carbonate, maybe this, can you see that? You are going to be having calcium chloride plus H2O plus CO2. So this carbon four oxide gas is the one that is actually causing that very particular effervescence. Are we together now? So we know the confirmatory test for that, because if you have lime water, I've said that before, I'll try to do that maybe on this channel. I'll try to do that. Passing CO2 gas into lime water, what happens? It turns the lime water milky. So can say that this has occurred with an evolution of an odorless and tasteless gas, which turns lime water milky. Okay? So if it is that, then here, friends, that will be CO2 gas from CO3 2 minus or HCO3 minus. Either of these two to liberate our CO2 gas. And they said to about 2 centimeter cube of the solution from 2 Ci, which means for this one now, just measure 2 centimeter cube to about 2 centimeter cube of this. Let me wash with water. I don't want this to actually. So let me wash this, my measuring cylinder, with water, with distilled water. Okay? Let me wash with distilled water. Then to about 2 centimeter cube of this. 2 centimeter cube of this. Let me measure. So I'm measuring 2 centimeter cube of this. Let's add another test tube. So about 2 centimeter cube of the solution from 2 Ci above. So 2 centimeter cube of this. They said I should add sodium hydroxide. Can you see that? This sodium hydroxide now. I'm adding sodium hydroxide. Let's watch. Let's see what is going to happen. Okay? Look at that. Can we see that now? We have a light blue solution. You have a light blue solution from there. I can still use this. I have a light blue solution. Okay. The residue. Can see that now. I have a light blue solution from there. Can see. Light blue. These traces of light blue. So to about 2 centimeter cube of the solution, add, so we have CII, the solution, Ci, I mean plus sodium hydroxide. Then we have a light blue solution formed. And when it is a light blue solution formed, what do you have? We have copper 2. You know that. That's copper 2. Present. Have you seen that? Then we followed by your ammonia, aqueous. Don't forget that, very important. Followed by our ammonia in drop and in excess. So followed by our ammonia in drop and in excess. There's our ammonia solution. Okay, this is our ammonia in drop from the light blue. Look at that, from the light blue. Then we have in drop. That's in drop and in excess. Can you see that now? In excess, in drop and in excess, what do we have? A deep blue solution is formed. Can we see? A deep blue solution is formed. So when we added this, we have what? A deep blue solution formed. And with the deep blue solution formed, it means our copper 2 is what is called Interesting. Our copper 2 ion is confirmed. Can you see? Deep blue solution is formed, which means our copper 2 ion is confirmed. Now from this, this is what they gave us. But so many students will omit this, and it might actually reduce the mark you're supposed to get for the practical. Look, they said something here. They said state the conclusion. You have not concluded. What you have done is your test, your observation, and your inference. You have not concluded. Okay, you have not concluded. So how do you conclude? Now the conclusion now. I will explain a bit of chemistry here just for a few minutes so that you understand how I concluded. Now, let's start from here. Look at the ion we confirmed here. That's SO42-. Can we see that? We confirmed what here? We confirmed ammonia gas from this. That's NH4+. Can we see? I'm picking those ions now. And from here, we are confirming, you know, from here, CO2 gas from CO32-. I'm picking that. Then I have copper. I'm not saying this is what you write for the conclusion. I'm just explaining something. Okay, let me just erase this. When I finish explaining them, I'll write the conclusion. You are not supposed to write this. I'm just explaining. Now look at this. Which means if this and this react together, we are going to have ammonia sulfate. Can we see that now? And if this and this react together, don't forget this copper 2 ion, it will give us what? Copper carbonate. Now look at this. This is what it's giving us. But this is not the salt. This is not the salt that you are giving. You know why? Because this first thing we did to the first portion of the filtrate add, okay, divide the filtrate, okay, this now dissolve all of C in about 10 centimeter cube of distilled water. When you dissolve in distilled water, the ions has been exchanged, because this is one of the way of preparing insoluble salt in the laboratory. This is one of the way of preparing insoluble salt in the laboratory. So the salt that you were giving is this. The salt that you were giving was ammonia carbonate and copper sulfate. So but when you added water, they reacted together. Look at this. You now have NH42 carbonate plus CuSO4 when you added water. And what is it now giving us? Because they will exchange their radical now. It will now be giving you ammonia sulfate and copper carbonate. Oh, interesting. Can you see that now? So the salt we are giving is this. But on adding water, what happened? It has been changed to this and this. And that's the reason why, if you look at your test, you got SO42-, which is this. You got ammonia, which is this. You got copper, which is this. And you are getting carbonate, or this hydrogen carbonate, which is this now. Can you see that? So the salt that you tested for was this and this. But on the addition of the two mixed with water, you are now producing this. Because in the laboratory, one of the way I said it, of preparing soluble salt is this. Ah, because this is soluble. This is what? Insoluble. So the residue you have is this. Why the filtrate we have is this. So if I want to produce copper carbonate in the laboratory, I want to prepare copper carbonate salt, I want to prepare it, I can use this double decomposition method to actually get this. I hope somebody is following. So what I'm concluding now is, my conclusion will now be, let me put it here so that you can actually see that over and over again if you want to write it. So my conclusion, please, you're not to write this for the sake of the exam. I'm just using this as an explanation. So my conclusion will now be sample C is a mixture of ammonia carbonate and what, and copper sulfate. Can you see that now? So that's your conclusion. So my conclusion will now be sample C is a mixture of ammonia carbonate and copper sulfate, because a lot of students will not do this, and they have stated it in the question that you tell us your conclusion from everything that you have done. So this is this. Now, take note, for the exam, they might ask you to do this before this, but all the tests will still give you the same observation and the same inference. You might start with this, this might come before this, and this might actually come before this. You know, in my own, you are adding barium chloride and ACL. They are what they might ask you to eat first, you know, stuff like that. They might try to change, but this is 75% or 80% of what you'll be needing for the number two for the chemistry practical. So that will be all for the number two. Please share this video to your friends. Tell them to subscribe, comment, like the YouTube channel. And I've said that we are still going to actually do some more exciting chemistry practicals here on this YouTube channel. So if you have not subscribed to this channel, please, I'm urging you to please subscribe. So share to your friends, tell your friends to subscribe, let your friend tell another person to subscribe, and let another person tell another person to subscribe. And that's how we can grow this YouTube channel together. Thank you.